Hey there, science explorers! It's Justin again. Look what I've found here at our pond. Some jelly-like eggs floating in the water. Have you ever seen eggs like these before? They're much different than the ones I ate for breakfast this morning, and the ones I've seen in birds' nests. They're see-through and slippery. Now, the big question for today, can we figure out who these eggs belong to? Let's put on our detective hats and solve this mystery together. Inside these eggs, something amazing is growing. What do you think it is? Well, there's one thing I do know. I know the eggs came from an oviparous animal. That's the word we use to describe animals who lay eggs. Animals that lay eggs and animals that don't lay eggs have different life cycles. Do you remember what that is? A life cycle is a series of stages that living things go through as they grow. So we know that oviparous animals lay eggs and that babies will eventually hatch out of them. But what happens inside the egg? And what happens after they hatch? Well, they can't stay babies forever. I think we have a lot of egg exploring to do today. Get it? Anyway, let's start with what we already know, the egg. We found these eggs in a bird's nest. Well, they look a bit more familiar, huh? And this is the first stage of an oviparous animal's life, the egg. But inside each egg, the second stage starts. An embryo begins its life. Right now, it's just a tiny little life form. It grows day by day, but it's not just sitting there, it's getting ready for a big change. Hatching is a big moment. With lots of effort, our little friend breaks free. But what do you think they look like? Are they mini versions of their parents? Or do they look different? Aw, they look the same, just a little smaller and cuter, of course. This is the third stage, a little hatchling. After the big hatch, the babies don't stop there. They then grow into juveniles. During this phase, the animals are growing quickly. Their bodies will soon resemble those of their parents. But they're not just getting bigger, they're changing in other ways too. They'll start to develop physical features characteristic of their species. For example, birds will grow feathers suited for flight, and juvenile turtles will develop harder, more defined shells. They'll also become more independent. They might join a group or pack, learn how to communicate with other members of their species, and learn important survival skills. And the final transformation brings the biggest changes. Our juveniles become adults, each with special features and behaviors. But the most exciting part? They're ready to start the cycle all over again with their own eggs. But not all babies start their life in an egg. Our mammal friends, like the beavers we saw last time, give birth to live young instead. So how does their life cycle look different from oviparous animals? Animals that give birth are called viviparous animals. Unlike our egg-laying friends, viviparous animals grow their babies inside their bodies. It all begins in a place called the womb, where the baby is protected and nourished until it's developed enough to survive in the outside world. The womb is a part of the body located in the abdomen, so as the baby grows, the mother's belly does too. This first stage is called gestation, and during this time, the baby receives nutrients and oxygen through an umbilical cord. When they're ready to be born, the mother gives birth to the baby, and it joins its family in the world. After they're born, viviparous infants grow quickly, but they still need help. Don't mammals have a special characteristic that helps them take care of their young? Oh yeah! For a while, they survive by drinking milk their mother makes, and by staying close to her. But soon, they learn to walk, find food, and play. When these babies reach their juvenile stage, they become much more independent. They start to explore more and learn social skills by interacting with other members of their species. This is their time to prepare for surviving as an adult. And finally, the animal reaches adulthood. Adult viviparous animals have the task of surviving on their own and starting the cycle over again by having their own babies too. Wow, both oviparous and viviparous animals lead pretty interesting lives. But, ooh, wait, I think something's happening. Look at this. Some of the jelly-like eggs we found have hatched. And something strange has emerged. It's not a fish. It's not a frog. Mia, help me out here. Aha, I see. This little creature wriggling around in the water is actually a tadpole. Yes, that's right. The second stage in the life of a frog. Oh, so these are frog eggs. Yep, frogs lay eggs. It's the first stage of their life. But their life cycle is a lot different from other oviparous animals. That's because frogs start their life in water and then live their adult lives on land. Baby frogs are called tadpoles, as we know, and at this stage, they're more like fish than frogs, swimming around and breathing through gills. Whoa, look at this. It still has a long tail like a tadpole, but it has back legs too. It doesn't have its front legs yet, though. It's in between a frog and a tadpole. Then their tails start to shrink, and they develop lungs for breathing air. This transformation is called metamorphosis, turning tadpoles into froglets, like that little guy on the left. And voila, the froglet becomes an adult frog, ready to hop out of the water and explore the land. And one day, it'll return to the water to lay its eggs, starting the cycle all over again. Whew, what an adventure we've had today. Thank you for helping me figure out who laid those eggs, and for learning about the life cycles of the animals at the pond with me. We've learned so much about freshwater life here, and I've really enjoyed it. I've enjoyed it so much that I think I want to learn about even more creatures who live in water. The Earth is covered by vast oceans, mysterious and brimming with life forms we've yet to discover. Imagine the wonders that await us in the salty waters of the sea. I'm Justin, and remember, the wildest discoveries are yet to come. Until our next journey, science explorers! Hey, hey.